wear a mean dark pair of shades.
Charlie Chaplin was your average high school student.
Unless my head is bent, you dig.
Captain of a high school football team. An active student in drama. He had everything. He had the car. The ladies. And the stash. He was filthy rich, and his parents had just made a fortune by investing in a new product. Nothing could stop this kid.
This. Pack your bags. There's a war. We're going to Europe.
It was 1917, and the United States has just entered war against Germany. Mr. Chaplin had just received a call from his draft officer, and it was to Europe he would go.
I've got sunburned, waiting for the chance to land.
Your father left, I've been scared. I've always needed a man in my house. But I'm no longer scared. You shouldn't be either. It's gonna be good.
Charlie, afraid of war, subconsciously uses regression as a defense mechanism, and reverts back to an earlier state of mind, specifically his Oedipal stage. Nevertheless, he goes to war. Charlie's sympathetic somatic nervous system acts up, engaging him in a fight or flight response. Here he fights.
Died, but seeing your face here, you know what? It's giving me some new hope inside of me. It makes my heart keep beating, you know? Charlie, Charlie, you show such a raw emotion when you cry. I know this guy. Yeah, he's a director. And I think you should act for him, man. I mean, what do you think, Charlie? Hey, good idea. Charlie, are you okay?
You made it rather rather
Being shot in the head, specifically the Broca's region, Charlie is able to comprehend speech, but is unable to speak it. The rest of Chaplin's life is history. He gets an acting career, and although most films around the time had sound, Charlie's films were unique in that they were silent. This silent legend became an outspoken success. And 15 years later, something miraculous happened. His Broca's area healed and he was able to make possibly one of the best video shorts of all time.
Soldiers, don't fight for slavery, fight for liberty. In the 17th chapter of St. Luke it is written, the kingdom of God is within man, not one man nor a group of men, but in all men, in you. You, the people, have the power to create machines, the power to create happiness. You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure. Then in the name of democracy, let us use that power. Let us all unite. Let us fight for a new world, a decent world.
His speech helped the Allies win World War II and solved many of the world's problems. Today, we are grateful for many of Charlie's wonderful contributions to society. Charlie won 29 Oscars throughout his acting career. He married a beautiful wife named Sylvia and had two children, Jack and Jill. After becoming a diplomat, he was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for his efforts in breaking up the Cuban Missile Crisis of 1961. 2 years after divorcing his wife, Charlie died in 1967. He will be remembered.